Here we go. Prosperity Mix, Grand Final versus Mick Xenoc. Managed to win all his matches in the loser bracket. Now we are playing a match best of five, and if I win that, I win the championship, and if Mick wins, we get to play another match because he comes from the lower bracket, and that means he has to win two matches to win the championship. We have Goat and Troom. He opened Pixie and what? Gladiator? Gladiator is a bit better than Silver with Goat around. You have a bit of a higher chance to hit early on. So ultimately, this will be some Horn Mega turn, I would guess. The draw is a bit weak, but Cities will probably get activated, so it should be fine. Yeah. Then you want lots of cities. Maybe get a Hireling in play at some point. I wonder what to pair Pixie with. Let's get the Pixie first. I mean, I could do double Pixie. Let's see what he does. So he does Gladiator. That makes me also want to go Gladiator because the Fortune will get revealed a bit earlier, and also you get a point if you trash a thing with the Gladiator. That was nice for him. And he does get the early Hireling. F5. So I can get a Spices or Forum, basically. Kind of like the Spices. And then let's see what the Pixie does. He might be inclined to take that just for the coins, and he might hit some number with it if he wants, like 5. Play last turn. So he does blow it up indeed. Another 6. Does he want a second Hireling already? Apparently he does. Well, I can take that for sure. And also take my Hireling, or do I take like triple Pixie? Probably triple Pixie is better than a Hireling. So it looks like he is colliding his Hirelings, which is good for me. Unless one is bottom decked for him. Okay. Pixies. We were talking about that before the game. Lots of tomb points for that. Keep. Reveal the goat. Rush is a Gladiator. Do I want a Horn now, or do I want a Hireling? That's not so clear. So clear. I think I'm taking the Horn. Yeah, I do have 2 terminals if I take the Hireling, which is not really what I want. On the other hand, whatever, 1 Hireling, it's nice to have. No. Thank you. Horn or City? I think reasonable. Let's take the Horn now. We have 2 terminals, but One of them is only for. He probably wants to take that. One of them is only for a moment. The hireling. Place a second hireling. It's kind of nice to have the spices. Put a plus by. Okay, so he also takes a plus by here. Should I take that? I don't. Oh, I don't think so. Just basically gains one pixie, but I have to discard two coppers. I think I'm taking that though to play my well, one of the terminals. I don't have a pixie now. Kind of sad. Goat. 1, 2, 3, 4. This can gain another horn and then buy a pixie, or should I gain the city? Nah, let's gain another horn. Pixie. That's okay, but it's not as great as it is when you get it very early. Lock? Nope, not with that one. So fortune revealed already, but I'm not really planning on getting that anytime soon. I don't really have much money. I mean, economy is horn and it doesn't really work with fortune. He has two hirelings out, which does take it. Interesting. Yep. Up to 6, that could be another hireling. I mean, I need the draw. How do we get to draw? The moment this is just hireling. Could take a city here and buy double pixie. That's kind of like the idea. Because I will have easier access to to the cities, because I have two horns. Let's hope I draw something here. Won't have that fortune. How much money can he generate? He does have a gold. So quite a bit. Also, he's also drawing back. But I'm not sure. If the fortune is better than having two horns. Now he has to think about offer spends. That was a bit annoying. We could spend it here, have 7, then double, then have 14, minus 8, 6. We could also not spend it. 12 minus 8, that's only 4. I guess he wants a horn, so I guess he will spend it here. Maybe he doesn't want a horn. We both have 11 VP from trashing things. Pretty even on that front, but our decks are, well, quite a bit different now with the horn versus the fortune. Yes, yeah, cities are very good now. Don't need a second hireling at this point. Ah, I forgot about the goat. And the coppers. So. Okay, here comes Fortune. So he does have quite a bit of money, that's impressive. It's another ducat for the buy. Okay, I see, that looks pretty good. Pixie, I'm not even sure that I need to take that. So he was drawing deck. At two coppers. So he still has two coppers, so I also still have two coppers. What are my last cards? That's the question. It's copper, it's city, it's another horn. Well, let's play it safe, even though that probably overkill, but whatever. I don't take that now. Okay, so yeah, it was overkill. I overdrew by two. I can reveal the spices. Wait a second. I still have enough cards, so I thought that I maybe should have played the city. Before I. Before I play my horns. Pretty sure I want another city. How was the deck drawing situation this turn? Well, it was bad. I should have bought a ducat, but I'm not going to bother now. Maybe I should, but I think I'm playing this without horn. The question is now, doesn't really matter, right? I'm going to trash the last couple next turn anyway. So I did draw deck exactly. Did I get greedy? Yeah, let's buy another horn and there's just nothing. yeah, was maybe a bit too greedy. So I took the Seas Gift. So there was Seas Gift, and then we shuffled the boons, apparently. There was another Seas Gift. So I have four horns. He has one fortune. Kind of didn't want to take the fortune because it also gives me that gold, and I just want to play my horns. Something like, what's it called? I always forget to do that, so that's a delayed show of the kingdom.
River's Gift, that's the name. That would be pretty good to get. Ash is his last. Nope, he has another one. Well, now he can double and have 20 again with 3 buys and a horn, so he can already could already quad. I see. Wonder why he spent that. These coffers. Because what are you doing with 20 that like 16 doesn't give you? Oh, do I need? I need an 8th unique, right? Huh. I have Pixie Horn Goat, City Hireling, Spices. Apparently, I do still have a copper. But if I like trashed that, I would need something like a forum or a silver. Well, or a fortune and a gold. Hireling City, Pixie, Horn, Goat, Copper, Spices, and Gladiator. So I do have 8 if I don't trash anything, if I counted correctly. Maybe. Okay, that's right. it is correct. But I kind of want to trash my oh, he can gain like double horn, double city now. That's scary. He has 3 horns now. Wow. Okay, well, it was kind of sad. I have to play my goat first. Okay, so, he does have 3 horns and he also has like 20 buying power, so that's 3 gains. Yeah, well, that's just bad. He does have 2 ducats. Fortune, so that's 4 thighs and 3 horns, that's 7 gains. I wonder what I take here. Hmm. 7 gains. Enough to win. Maybe I take like easy. City Forum. Does he have 8 uniques? He has Hireling, City, Horn, Gold, Fortune, Gladiator, Ducket, Gold. Yeah, he does have 8. That's unfortunate. I wonder if I have to gain duchies here. I have to gain duchies. 4 gains. Forum City, Duchy, Duchy. Maybe not another city, but another horn instead, and then double dead sheep, but then I. It's just too bad. That turn kills me. Horn. Double dead sheep here, 7 gains. No, he has 3 horns, right? So that's. He does have 7 gains. What's the last one? I think it has to be a city. I mean, he has 7 gains. And last one is a province, so if he draws, he wins regardless. Yeah, I don't know. This last horn should have probably been. Wow, that's a complete dud, really. Kidding me. That's insane. Well, I'm saying it's a dud, but he probably does have all his money and a fortune in hand, so he might still be able to do quite a bit. Maybe I should have played a bit more for the dud by taking, by not trashing for that dud sheet. That might have been dumb. But let's see, this turn should be good. He cannot really take the last horn. Well, actually he could. But he knows that I will have a turn now. Let's trash his last copper. Interesting. So I draw, I win. So let's see. I guess we start with one city. Then we do Pixie. Crash that. And then discard like that should be it. It's got 2 cards. I'm even drawing them back up. Reveal the duchy and then I can pile. Nice. That was lucky. Well, sort of. That he, well, it was lucky that he died it completely, but I was also a bit unlucky that I died it the turn before
All in all, fortune was probably good. Okay. Oh. One for me. It's first to three. I said best of five earlier, but if the score is tied at 2.5, 2.5, we, I think we continue playing until it's not a tie, which, well, shouldn't be that long. No, that's the new board. Where I should go first. That doesn't look very prosperity-ish. Okay, so, well, there's no village other than sacrifice. This forum, which is very good. I wonder if you what do you do? Do you open Marauder or do you just skip Marauder and play Sacrifice? I think I open. Well, I already do have a silver now. Do I really need another one? Could open Fool Sacrifice. Doesn't seem terrible. I usually don't like to open Fool as the first player because you might get stolen that Lost in the Woods right away if they open Fool as well. Well, I think this is just money with Council Room, maybe some forums. Maybe even not. Well, you can train something. I'm not really seeing the pool. Let's do Silver Sacrifice. He opens Forum with a 5-2, which probably bet. No, I also like the Sacrifice. Here I hit 6 out of nowhere, and I wonder what I want to do with that. So I guess I play with lots of, just given my draw and that I hit Sneak 6 now, play with lots of Forums and train them. Maybe. This will be a patrician. Do I take another silver? Yes, I take another silver. Here I put forum on top. Buy another patrician. Okay, I get to sacrifice an estate here. And Emporium's revealed already. Discard 2 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't really know what to buy here if I sacrifice the estate. If I sack a copper. F6, is that even true? 1, 2, 3. And I have to sacrifice an estate though, it's what you do here. And then what? I could buy a humble castle here. Doesn't seem outrageous. If I pilgrimage, I don't really doesn't really do much. Yeah, feeling like a castle somehow. So I got that artisan, but it probably, well, it will put me some forums on top. Yeah, I have six. It's probably just another forum. I could also train the forums now. Possibly better. I want to sack more estates. He has the forums going. He should be ahead here. Trains them, well, makes much more sense for him than for me. So this is 8. I think it's just a province. I could do like forum fool, maybe. Lost in the Woods isn't that great with forums, to be honest. It's just province. Yeah, I can either, I think I'm, I can sack, that patrician. And I think I'm doing that. Yeah. Let's play the forum first. And put like, and play a council room here if I want to. Or just another forum. And also top deck a forum now. let's play that council room. Bye. Province crumbling, I guess. Okay, that's not a great turn for him, given the amount of forums he has, but next turn he should be playing like most of them. He only has one buy. It's a forge now. Well, yeah, he can do that. Certainly, is it forum or is it small? I think it's a castle. He might get the haunted one. So be it. I wonder if I should just buy Emporia just to deny him the points. That might be a thing. I am trashing this crumbling. Or whatever castle will be on top. And then I can either buy a forum or an emporium, or if I get attacked here by the haunted castle, just nothing, then I will top tick 2 silvers. So he gets a good forge in now, I would guess. Maybe he can trash triple estate. Yeah, that's what he will do, right, for the haunted. That's what he will do, most likely. Can't buy anything then. So maybe he doesn't do that. It's a bit of a pity that I only was able to trash one estate with my sacrifice. Trading the forum was probably also not worth it for me. I thought I might get a couple more, but didn't really happen. Thing with Portia is, well, he can filter with all these forums, but there is no real draw, and having said that, why does he... Okay, Patrician, he drew something with Patrician, obviously. But yeah, trashing is so hard here, and there's a lucky coin, which really makes the money strategies pretty good. That's why I just didn't want to trash here. But yeah, given that he had a 5-2, I think what he did was quite
reasonable.
I would have gone Marauder if it wasn't for Sacrifice on the board, I think. Even though Trashing Ruins is not like... Yeah, here we go. I'm taking the silver so I can potentially buy Province next turn. But Forum... Okay, here I just play the council room. I wonder if he will try to snipe some castles. I guess he will empty the Emporia first. Then he also has to watch out for the piles. Maybe he's just doing provinces. Should be able to province pretty consistently, I think. I wonder if I hit 8 here, what do I do? Hopefully I don't draw my artisan dead here with the council room. Yeah, if I hit 8, take province, that would take sprawling. Probably take sprawling. Yeah, better. I wonder if he should pick up owns the room or a wine merchant at some point. Maybe not yet, but he does have lots of money with all these drained forums, and he has only one buy. Well, forum gives you half a buy. If you buy a forum, you can buy something else. I'm expecting another forge here. Maybe should also get a sacrifice to sack some of his patricians so that he can play artisan and forge, or Artisan and whatever plus buy he wants, if he ever wants one. If I don't draw the artisan dead, then that would be quite cool. Top deck another forum then, and then that should give me another province, hopefully. Comes the forge. Wonder. Still has the estates, right? Doesn't really need to trash all of his points. Well, first of all, because he needs points, and also with the forums, you don't really care what you discard. Might as well be some estates. Maybe he just trashes something into province. Or the sprawling. Okay, he does take the sprawling. Forum and the grand, then. Don't give him any points, though, and it also Well, I'm not likely to hit 10 is the thing here. But I do. It's nice. Just take the king. Okay, nice. Forum in hand. It was pretty good to take that King's Castle. Now he has to rely on provinces and Emporia, well, and duchies. Still think he's ahead, but I'm not sure anymore. I wasn't really totally sure before that, but bad I didn't have 13 last turn, but only 12. Wait, never mind. For a second I thought I bought the castle for 8, but it was the one for 10, so that wouldn't have changed anything, except that I would have bought a silver. Probably artisans for an emporium this turn and buys like province. Expect. Then has that forge. Maybe he can also just double province somehow. Even though it's not that easy with his deck composition and the amount that the cards cost. Trash into 8. He did trash 2 estates last turn. So he has 1 estate left. Who has the gold? Do I have a gold? No, you gain it with that haunted castle, right? Yeah, so he can trash like estate and gold into province if he wants. Then buy a province maybe. He can do so much more than me with all these forums, obviously. There's this cool new feature with Siviri script that you can see the spectators without typing in slash who. I wonder if they all or if they just end because it's the end of the page. But whatever. Good thing about my deck is it's not that difficult to play. Oh, you can also trash Forum and Silver, obviously, into a province. And his patricians did quite something here again, wow. Hit 9 cards in hand. I drew him 1, so 3 patricians drew? Is that even possible? All of them drew? Looks like it's possible, yeah. Nah, that's pretty nice for him. He does have lots of 5 costs, to be fair. Still a bit fortunate for him. So, okay, yeah. The artisan had to go. That's 7. 7 is a bad number. Guess just that she then. Anything else? And also that the artisan missed is pretty bad. Yeah, that should have been 8. Probably double again here, and that should seal it more or less. Though doubling now, well, possible. Yeah, not sure what to say here. Triggers that, which he probably doesn't care about because four rooms, and draws again. Yeah, the way this looks, in case Mick wins this match, you're probably not going to play the next one right after that. Because we're already almost an hour in, and it's still game two. Yeah, double. That's the thing. It's a silver. Well, in top deck, Council Room, but I rather top deck it. Well, I don't top deck the Duchy, but. Yeah, okay. I mean, Province Duchy is pretty safe for him now that he saw that I played my Artisan. And if you can't do that, you can just do Duchy or double Duchy. But well, that's just played out. Take too long. Maybe he can, he can probably just mill one and buy one. Yeah, that's what he will do. Okay, so that's a re-break. Fortunately. Okay. Another goat game. Mountain Pass. This village and draw and all the stuff and trashing. So let's see what I have here. I'm not sure. I never really hit 5 all that often, is the thing. Okay, onto this game though. What is it? Lots of options. Eventually, you want to play with Plaza and Wild Hunt. How do you get there? Do you open? Do you open Monument?
I don't think that you need to open temple or something with the goat around. Marauder, meh. Not a fan. I think I kind of like the monument open and pair it with either a forager or a pixie. Let's see what he does. He agrees on the monument. Let's see if he goes for forager. I think kind of want that as well. Maybe pixie is better because you might pick up a counterfeit early. Let's try the pixie. That's a super ugly draw, but I will hit 5 next turn, so should be fine. Actually, this will be a plaza, be a counterfeit. Keep plus one card, always nice. Not always, but I think people, they don't trash their pixie often enough in the early game for pretty decent boons. Does he get a white hand already, or does he just do plaza pixie? White hand it is. Plaza. Same for me, I guess. Could see second plaza, but I'd prefer to have the wild hand. Maybe he also gets a counterfeit. All right, fair enough. Okay, let's take them. I wonder. Do have 6. I will buy Plaza Pixie. Well, so then I shouldn't. Well, no. Doesn't make much sense. I wonder if I should trash the goat here. Trash 2 coppers and buy a plaza. Probably a bit too early for that, so I could also not trash a plaza pixie. But trashing is good, so do that. Dang it. Hope to hit 4 or 5 here. Well, that's kind of likely, but never know. Yeah, trashing the goat there was not that crazy. Trash is one more card for the moment, and well, no. I still have one estate, and I need to trash that with the gold, so it wasn't really a thing. What did he take? Takes 1 gold. Gold is a good card. He also doesn't get to play plaza before wild hunt, and also only a pixie, but he did gain the gold, so okay, only 4 by the plaza. There are 3 plazas now, which is good. He does have a gold forager. It's good for him. I think he should take another plaza here and not another wild hunt. Not another wild hunt. But he might also go wild hunt pixie. That's also totally fine. But I think I would go plaza pixie in his spot. He does that. Play the Wisp first. Takes a wild hunt, so that's good. So this is double plaza. Yeah. Okay. Take that. I can take more wild hunts. Have 5 plazas. Would be nice to have 6, which I can take if I want them. Kind of want them. I wonder. I have 5 plazas that draws 5 cards. Wild Hunt draws another 3. Draws 8. So I wonder if I should. Yeah, I think I should start with the plaza here. And maybe if I draw my Wild Hunt and find all my plazas, I can safely discard a copper and draw it back up with Wisp. Should have exactly the draw for that between 5 plazas and a wild hunt that draws 8, and then I have 1 card on top of my deck and I can play Will-O-Wisp. Having said that, I just realized that I have 2 wisps, so and maybe even discard twice. But I still should start with playing the plaza. At least 1 and then another and then see. Oh, triple plaza, okay. So we split them, that was good for him. The gold did its job there. Don't have to discard for the first one, I don't think. We'll discard for the second one though. Okay, 1 wisp now. Open my hand, nice. Now, a plaza. Good. All right, and discard here. I want to fit just a copper. And then maybe. So I have some money here. Probably not trashing this copper. Can buy like double Wild Hunt or Wild Hunt Monument or Wild Hunt Gold. Who buys? Do I ever need 3? Probably not. Double Wild Hunt seems good here. It might take the points, actually. But then he doesn't really draw all that much. He does draw with 5 plazas, so. I get double wild hunt, is there anything useful that I can get other than that? Well, wild hunt gold. Gold doesn't really inspire me. Plaza is basically economy with the ability to discard and draw back up. I think double wild hunt it is. Yeah, I think he takes that. Yeah, he probably takes the points now. Maybe he doesn't, I don't know how much he cares about them. Looks like he does take them, otherwise he would have discarded a copper here. But he does make his turn quite sad, I think. Can't buy much here. Probably will be enough for another wild hunt though. Yes, Straw. But later, or again, I wonder, I just have to take. Even though it's only 2 points, I can take them for free. Gold Wild Hunt looks decent to me. There's something to be said about buying copper at some point. Maybe I do need another counterfeit. Probably not this turn though. 6 plus 5 is 11. I would need to spend 4 coppers. Exactly that. Always nice to see Plaza and Wild Hunt in the starting hand. Should be slightly ahead here with 4 Wild Hunts. 2 buys next turn. Wonder if I really need to get another counterfeit. Maybe for the buy, so maybe I can buy free stuff. You know, copper isn't the worst card here. It's a good discard target for Plaza and can be easily drawn back up with the Will-O-Wisp. But probably we won't have time for all of that because the states and the wild hunts are gonna run. Does he just take one estate here? The wild hunt? Yes, he does. Doesn't want to leave any for me. Makes sense. Probably also gold wild hunt. Maybe double wild hunt, double wild hunt. Yeah, you have to keep an eye on the estate pile out. With gaining lots of states with the wild hands. So so I'm doing points. Now Rush that estate, counterfeit, hopper. I mean, it's super nice to have three buys, I gotta admit that. What am I buying? Maybe I don't trash that copper. Currently I have 9, 10, 13. Could be something like province wild hunt. But I would have to spend these coffers. All the pixies are in the trash. Two treasures in the trash for forager. But I don't want a forager. Robin's Wild Hunt is interesting because it also triggers the mountain pass. I could also do just province. Seems interesting not spending these five coffers for another wild hunt. If he then bids very high, like 40, then he can't win. So I think I'm doing that. Maybe spend two coffers for a pixie. Or just trash that copper and buy it back. Well, but then didn't achieve much. Didn't really track the boons. I think I'm doing exactly this. Buying a province and see what he bids. Should have thought about the bidding beforehand, but let's see. I have no clue what he's up to now with the bidding. Can't bid super high. Let's just give him the points. Yeah, probably just standard like 13-ish. 12, maybe. our monuments have done quite a bit there. Maybe at some point I should have done a Wild Hunt monument where I went wild and gold, but I think not. I mean, I did have the terminal space for it, but one less economy per turn is quite annoying, even though it comes with a point per turn, so I'm not sure. So he bid 11. If I give him that, how many points is that? 8. It
say that I take the 12. I have quite some debt. I don't think he can buy double wild hunt, and maybe he can buy one. But I kind of think it's a bit low. Gimme. So now 13-point lead, which is quite something. We both have 4 wild hunts and 5 plazas in the monument. And a count of it in the gold. Here's the forager. I have a province. The copper front. And also he still has 1 estate. Right? Yeah. 11 VP, but... I mean 11 chips, VP chips, but 12 VP. So he will probably buy province plus. Something. Maybe also only just province. Yeah. Oh, this one will go. Does have that gold somewhere. And I would assume with the counterfeit. But I don't think he will counterfeit it, so he does have 8. Can I? No. No, I cannot do that, because I have 12 dead, so I cannot pile anything here. Well, I can maybe pile estates and buy a province. That would be maybe good. But it would require to play 2 wild hunts for points, and I probably can't afford that. I need to draw with them. I'm probably just... What am I talking? I won't be buying a province this turn. I have 12 dead. Yeah, maybe 11 was a good bit. But I think 12 would have been a bit better. Okay, I see you're playing for the long game. What else do you expect from me, right? Don't have to discard here. Got the copper here. Draw. Again, I guess. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. So. Well, first I can. Doesn't really matter, actually. Why does it say 6 dead? Well, because that happens when I play gold and copper. So, what I think that I'll just counterfeit the copper. It's five, and then trash the state and buy nothing. We trash the estate. We should have 16 points lead. Think I'm buying a copper here. Is it too greedy? I don't think so. But one should be enough. Wait, no. I don't wanna. I miscounted my. So I'm not out of debt here. But maybe I should still do it. I mean, I can buy two estates, mind you. Can buy two estates. That is probably good, right? Then there are two wild hunts left, and I have a big lead. Double province doesn't do much for him. I can hit 10, 3, 5. Yeah. So let's spend what is it? Three coffers and then another four? Seven coffers? Okay, nice. With the Plaza Wild Hunt again. And, well, he does have two golds and two counterfeits. That is 6, 7, 8, 9, 15. And the forager, that's 17 gold. Well, that's already, no, that's mine, that's in the trash. No, that's not. No, he can't win. Maybe he can do something like double province duchy. Double province duchy to catch up, and then I might have, well, forgot about the monument. Might end in a tie. Might end in a tie. So he has double counterfeit on that. Yeah, the forager is pretty nice. I'm sitting there with two buys the whole game, which is a problem, but I think it was still fine under the given circumstances. Maybe he shouldn't even have trashed that estate, but I guess he kind of had to because otherwise he doesn't have anything else to trash. I only have two buys. Yeah. I can only buy double wild hunt, but that's it's not winning if he buys double promise duchy here. Well, actually it is. Because he trashed his estate. So he would be at 31 after double province duchy. That's intriguing. Can he cannot do double province double duchy, right? So now he has two golds and two counterfeits in hand, so if he counterfeits a counterfeit, that's three more money. And then the golds are 12. Only 15 and 7 coffers. 24. Oh! Triple. What am I thinking about if he but why doesn't he? Why doesn't he triple? Well, because it would kill all his golds, I suppose. Which is bad, but he basically plays for the dud now, or what? What's the idea here? Must be the case. Probably buy province duchy then. Province monument, that's reasonable. But yeah, okay, let's see. This time I play the wisp first, or do I? Probably actually don't. Should have thought about that during his turn. Yeah, let's see. Plaza. This card here. Or whatever that is worth. Yeah, that should be it. Okay, he's resigning, which is reasonable. Okay, pretty nice. But he could have tripled, but again, then his economy is crippled, so. Yeah, probably that wasn't a good idea either. Maybe not trash the estate and do double province duchy. That leaves it. No. It wasn't a tie because I. Well, because he trashed the estate. And he has to trash the estate, is what I mean. Interesting. Okay. Set up the new board. Already starting. New table, that's a bug if there are some number of spectators that sometimes randomly appears. Okay, spec chat is off. Let's go. So I would need to win this game to clinch the title. And I'm first player, is that correct? Yeah. Okay, so he was first player in the last one. Nice. Okay, that looks more like what you imagine of these boards, at least from my experience in the past matches. The open is a bit slow because you have to buy some things like silver here, for example, and then I'm not a fan of buying a potion here, so I'm probably not going to. Because the draw, so he does go for the potion. Let's think about that. Somehow I'm not a big fan of potion here. It's infinite draw. If you hit 6, you can just buy hunting crowns or board a village council room. Nah, let's two double silver, and this is sad. Could be just fun villa because you need them eventually, and they gain you peddlers later. But hitting five is also, well, hitting five is council room. We did seven at some point. Let's do villa. You like the like the level 45s on leather, and he hits six. What the strike is that? So this is another silver then. Okay, so I hit six. Border village, council room, or hunting grounds. Eyes are nice for peddlers. Drawing four cards is better than drawing three, and also drawing him a card. Well, no, sorry, never mind that. They both draw four cards, but I don't want to draw him a card. Water village council room is two action cards, which might be useful for city quarters later. And that's another council room then. But he did miss his alchemist at least. Okay, super sad. Might be another council room or a horn. Probably another council room. I have three now, which is pretty crazy. Okay, now I can buy some stuff. You know, you have that six potion, and what you're gonna buy now? Probably not an alchemist, I don't think. Well, maybe, but so what's the goal here? I guess eventually you're gonna pick up wands and then make a turn with them. So that's what I should be doing this turn, I guess. Villa Alchemist. Okay, yeah, I can see that with the free villa. Sure. Nothing to put in that shuffle because I can't do villa tricks then. So kill the thing. Well, I don't have any more. Draw, do I? Last cards are Copper Estate and man, this is gonna be crazy. Once we overdraw with Villa, and another is that another Villa? That last card. We have three silvers. Okay, right, I did buy another silver, so let's get that. Now I have five buys, which is a good number. Well, do we even need a council room right now? Well, we can council room a villa. So what is this? council room, triple peddler, quad peddler. Excuse me. Probably. I mean, I would like to get the horn, but you can't, so. Should I take a free villa? No. Yes. I don't know the answer to that one. Let's go with no. Oh, I didn't buy it. Lol. Okay, that was embarrassing, but so it goes. Yeah, that was bad, and then also the draw was super sad. Man, hope that doesn't come back to bite me. Yeah, that was stupid. Council room already gone, so let's start something like that. Okay, so here can buy like one. Or maybe just council room villa. Good. Well, I can take some free peddlers if I want. Should take a pick up the aqueduct points here, maybe. Maybe also not. So there's another council room. Twelve would have been cool. Dabei. Okay, maybe like don't take the horn yet. I can always take it later. Taking a state here. It's basically a province. Don't have a good King's Court target, really. States. Okay, so I guess Peddler is my King's Court target. Starting with Villa Council Room here, I think. Turn continues, I would assume. Yeah, estate pile out is the main thing to watch out for. Yeah, that's the case. No way of trashing Hunting Grounds though, except you get Flame's Gift from Idle. I have 3 silvers and 7 coppers, it's 13, and then I have like 6 peddlers, it's 19. And then I have like 4 villas, 23. If I king some things, that's like close to 30. And that is villas cost 3. Basically 12 plus 16. Yeah, I can. If I draw, I can already pile. So should I just? Can he pile? Well, that would be a shame. I don't think he has the bias because he doesn't have council rooms. Yeah, whatever. Ah, okay, yeah. At this spot, okay. I thought you meant earlier. Robins? So I think I can pile estates if I draw, but I think I should quickly check that because if I can money wise, then I should start with kinging the council room. So I have 7 coppers and 3 silvers. That's 13. I will get to king a peddler. Like 16. I have say 5 more peddlers, that's 21, and then I have 4 villas, so that's 25, maybe 14. It's kind of close. Man, do I really have to figure out how many peddlers I have? And villas. So I have 4. Three villas and 7 coppers is 10, and silvers is 16. At least a peddler. Let's say it is 22. Villas costs 3, so that's 12. That wouldn't be enough. Okay. That's bad. King, 1 peddler. Player council room. No, I don't have the bias. Shoot. Oh, yeah, that's nice. Let's see what It does. I forgot that I have three king's courts. This is just villa, right? For the buys and the coins. I'm already at 12. That's 15. 25. 13. Yeah, that is enough. Isn't it? 23, 29, these cost 12, 27, 7 estates. But you can resign, I don't mind it in this case. But whatever. Okay, cool. I win that one 3-1. Pretty cool games. Yeah, I didn't like the potion here. That was the main thing. Because the board is just too explosive. I mean, so much other draw, and yeah, potion is just too slow. He didn't hit Alchemist turn 3 or 4, which was unfortunate, but he did hit 6, so. Anyway, that's it for this tournament. Just for the sake of completeness, 3-1 to me, and see you around. Bye bye. Thanks for watching.